Your Excellencies, distinguished invitees, members of the NPP Business Forum, and my dear friends. Since I set up my business in 1995, I have achieved a significant financial success and a solid reputation within the community. However, there were two instances where our joint ventures were set up with foreign collaboration and investment based on the confidence the investors had in me and my organization. In both these instances, the investors opted to pull out even after they had invested funds due to the unwarranted bureaucracy, and as a result, the ventures had to be shut down. 2 years ago, I had the privilege of engaging with senior members of the NPP, which gave me the opportunity to interact and understand their ingenuity. The way they worked in an inclusive manner, engaging experts in various specialties here and abroad to formulate a practical, comprehensive plan to revitalize our nation's economy with clarity, strength, transparency, and accountability to the public who will mandate the NPP on the 21st of September 2024. The recent rumors about property ownership, travel restrictions, credit card restrictions, stock market, and so on, is with the malicious intention of driving fear among you, the elite business community of Sri Lanka. An NPP government will support and facilitate business and individual prosperity, without which we cannot boast of being the facilitators of a successful nation. If not for this sentiment, I myself would not be here to support the Herculean task they are about to take upon themselves. As the business community of Sri Lanka, you can look forward to a government that will embrace your feasible business propositions and take down the barriers of bureaucracy that has restricted the growth of your organization and individual prosperity. In conclusion, I humbly request you, the business community of Sri Lanka, to support the NPP in this decisive election and enjoy the fruits of prosperity. Thank you.
Thank you very much, member of the Jathika Janabala Vegaya Business Committee, Mr. Shiranta Pieris. We are also expecting the arrival of the leader of Jathika Janabala Vegaya, Mr. Andru Kumar Dissanayake, very soon. Do keep your fingers crossed. In the meantime, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to call upon the managing director for multiple businesses, including MN Group of Companies Private Limited in Australia and New Zealand. Please welcome Mr. Manu Amunugama to say a few words.
Good evening, everyone. I never expected such a big crowd. My name is Manu Amunugama, businessman living in Australia for past 23 years. We have a few businesses, property maintenance, Australia and New Zealand, property maintenance, landscaping and engineering, travels, and imports and exports. So many people are asking from me, why that we don't come and invest in Sri Lanka? Not that we don't like to invest in Sri Lanka, because Sri Lanka is my mother country. Mage putala thundena ma ipadune Lankave. So we love to invest in Sri Lanka. The reason that, main reason we don't want to come and invest in Sri Lanka because of this dirty political culture. Bringing an investment to Sri Lanka, if we had to go behind politicians and their secretaries to set up the business, I don't think that any investor will like it. Because we have not got used to that type of culture. In Australia, to set up a business, maximum might take 3 to 4 days, working days. And we are doing a lot of government contracts, council contracts in Australia. For past 23 years, I have never ever gone behind a politician to set up my businesses or to discuss any of my businesses. I mean, that type of environment that we are working there. I'm expecting the same culture here. If I had to come as an investor to Sri Lanka, there are three areas that I am very much concerned. Number one is law and order. රටේ නීතිය කියන එක තියෙන්න ඕනේ හැමෝටම එක සමානව. ඒක මේ ප්‍රෙසිඩන්ට් වෙන්න පුළුවන්, ප්‍රයිම් මිනිස්ටර් වෙන්න පුළුවන්, පොලිටිෂියන්ස්ලාට වෙන්න පුළුවන්, සාමාන්‍ය මිනිස්සුන්ට වෙන්න පුළුවන්. If there's no proper law and order, I don't think you all can bring any investor to Sri Lanka. That is number one. Number two, easy way to set up a business. We should be able to get to organize our businesses through one department, one window, one point. So that means that we don't want to go to set up a business. If you have to go to department to department, grama sevaka gen palat sabhaven pradesh sabhavata aya palat sabhavata e wage kaalayak waste karanna thiyenona nan I don't think any investor will come. So number 3 is there are so many departments that you all may have to bring it to a digital platform, especially customs. You will have to bring customs to a digital platform. The reason actually I came for this meeting, I have for past 23 years, I have seen many politicians are coming to, Sri Lankan politicians are coming to Australia. But none of them contacted us so far just to have a chat or to encourage us to come and invest here. No politician contacted us. Mama hithanne samanya me hari politician kenek nan lanka pitradakata yanawa nan e rate inda Sri Lankan me business karana ayo contact karala ekatit ekka discuss karanna one. The only politician who contacted us is Anurag Kumara Dissanayake. Before he come to Australia, he contacted us. We had couple of Zoom meetings, and after coming to Australia, he kept one full day to meet all the business entrepreneurs in Australia. We had meetings. He visited all our business places and discussed with us and invited us to come and invest here. මේ මට මතකයි තාමත් අනුර කීප එකක් තමයි ඔය කට්ටිය රටට ගැළපෙන මේ ව්‍යාපාරයක් අරගෙන එන්න අපි ඔය කට්ටිය සම්පූර්ණයෙන්ම ආරක්ෂා කරනවා බලා ගන්නවා. Bring good investments to Sri Lanka, we will look after you, we will protect you. ඒ වගේම තව දෙයක් කිව්වා, රටට නොගැළපෙන එකක් ගේන්න එපා, අපි කොච්චර මේ යාළුවෝ වුණත් ඒකට අපි ඉඩ තියන්නෙත් නැහැ කියලා. මම හිතනවා මම හිතනවා දැන් ඇත්තටම ලංකාවට අවශ්‍ය මෙන්න මේ වගේ පොලිටිෂන්ස්ලා. සල්ලි වලට මුදල් වලට ගන්න බැරි නිහතමානී ඒ වගේ ලීඩර්ෂිප් ක්වොලිටිස් තියෙන කෙනෙක් තමයි ලංකාවට අවශ්‍ය. ඉතින් මගේ එකම රික්වෙස්ට් එක දැන් මෙතන අනුර හිටියා නම් I want to tell this to his face. Please implement a proper system here. Establish a proper law and order. Make a beautiful environment where investors to come and invest in this country. I'm pretty sure that NPP and Anurag should be able to do this. Good luck, everybody. Thank you.